Hello, OSD Cloud fans. So, in the previous video, we looked at how you can get started with OSD Cloud, and we built that WinPE, Boot Media, ISO or USB or whatever you had to get you into the command prompt environment where you can do stuff like start OSD Cloud. And that's what I demonstrated in the previous video as the less optimal way to run OSD Cloud. I suggested there was a better way. I want to go through that now. This has all come about in the past sort of week or so. I've been a bit lax in keeping up to date with David Segura's developments. They are daily, so it is quite hard to keep up to date. But one of the most important updates was ScriptPad. So I'm going to go through that just now. Let's take a look at my Twitter just to see what David said about it, and then we'll go quickly into what it's all about. So here we have a big change in this release, and it essentially allows you to open a public GitHub or assign a public GitHub to ScriptPad. So what's ScriptPad? Well, essentially it's a way to, in WinPE, access all the scripts you've got in the GitHub repo. And it can be any public GitHub repo that you specify at the command line. And it took me a little while to understand how big a deal that is, and I'm going to just show you it right now because it is a big deal. So as you can see, obviously Gary Block, fantastic, contributor to the community. This is the repo that David suggested you take a look at. I'm going to go with mine. I've only got one script, but obviously I'll use mine because it's me. So I'm going to grab this this bit of the command. So we'll start with pretty much where I left you in the previous video, which is in command prompt running as PowerShell, ready to crack on with installing OSD Cloud. So we're going to go with install module OSD, give that a few seconds to install, and then we'll just type the command that we picked up from Twitter, which is start-scriptpad, I think. So the command we found in Twitter was hopefully in my clipboard, and there it is. So start-scriptpad, the Git owner, in this case it's me, and the Git repo is getmodern. Just press enter on that. As you can see, it heads off to the GitHub API to pick up my content, and in a few seconds we'll show a GUI interface of the scripts that I've got within my my repo. So why is that important? Well, this script, for example, is, I don't think, is a script I've written. It seems to be there by default, but I've got another one, which is OSD Cloud. And what I've done is taken the liberty of copying all of David's stuff and put it into my own script, which is this one here. So with one command, which is effectively this one here, start script pad, and then my repo, I can do all of these things that I've already scripted. And there's an example on Twitter that you will have just seen that you can use any public GitHub repo to do anything you want within WinPE. This is all running in WinPE, remember. So if I click on start process, that will then kick off everything I've got scripted in that repo, which will, you won't be able to see it just now, but I'll take a look in the repo, which, so for example, it's going to build a 21H1 Windows 10 Pro English, British, machine, and it will set these things for the autopilot out of box experience JSON. It will then also remove these Apex packages. It will update the drivers and update Windows, and it will then do this autopilot registration for me. So in one command, it's done all of this stuff. And that could be any other PowerShell script that I want to write, or pick up from any other content creator on GitHub. And that is incredibly powerful, you have to admit. So as I say, that is possibly the better way to use OSDCloud rather than writing your own commands as you see fit. So I'm going to troll Twitter, speak to David, and see what else we can demonstrate, essentially, because this is a goldmine as far as I can see, and I'll be posting more content in the next few days. See you next time.